Something that can make you do wrong, make you do right. My name is Nicholas, and I'm Italian American. I'm based in Italy in a small city called Perugia, and I'm a music producer, a record collector, and besides from this, I'm also a law school graduate. So I used to work in a law firm, and I'm doing my bar exam this year. So I'm balancing music and law. That's basically what I'm doing. I started listening to house music, let's say in the late 90s, and once I discovered house, I just started like researching the roots of house music, discovering the classics, and then going always back, and I found out about disco, boogie, and all that stuff, and that's how I built my music culture, buying records. I started making music, let's say around at least 6-7 years ago. And on the side I was buying records, but I wasn't DJing. And when I started to put out some records and getting like requests for parties and stuff, I thought the most like logical step was to do a live show with my own music and some equipment, and instead of becoming DJ all of a sudden. But especially after a couple of years I've been doing a live set a lot, I'm starting to feel the need also to play other people's music. Sometimes after I finish the live set, I do like 1 hour, 1 hour and a half. Sometimes if the vibe is right, I play a couple of records that are not mine, like old classic and stuff like that. And especially lately, I'm feeling the need to play other people's music. And you know, I'm working on my DJ skills, and I don't know when, but probably I'm gonna be on the decks. Sooner or later. Find my message in a bottle. Someone sees me. The heart inside. Before making the stuff that I put out in the past 2 or 3 years, my sound was very different. I was making more of like a techno house sound. It was also very influenced by African rhythms. I was influenced by records like Sandcastles from Dennis Ferrer, this early Ibadan stuff, and that's the type of music I was making in the beginning. It was very electronic and had like tribal elements to it. So it was more close to techno than, it definitely wasn't classic, wasn't traditional. And I still make that kind of tracks, and in the future I have some releases planned that have some different sounds, more techno.
Somebody, one body, I need somebody.
I haven't been doing any collaborations. I mean, I did very few because I think to do a collaboration, you need to be in the same studio. You know, I can't work via the internet. I can't. A lot of people do that. I can't. For me, I like to work with vocalists, for example, because I used to, in the beginning, I used to sample my vocals. I'm excited because it's been years from now that I've heard about this club, actually. I remember years ago, many years ago, I used to watch a lot of videos from this club. All my heroes, the American DJs, they were all playing here. I remember watching like I don't know, Team of Regisford play here and all, you know, these American guys that they've been basically my heroes. And, you know, I was always, I didn't know about the club scene in Paris, but for me, you know, it was all about this club, June, because every time I looked up videos on the internet, these guys that I was listening to were always playing here. So for me, it's a privilege to be here tonight.